6 p.m., Cam McCubbin, and I guess his final newscast. Congratulations on your move to Ottawa, Cam, and the best of luck from all of the gang. Then J. Paul McConnell in sports, and then Terry Moore, 6:15 to 9. Me, I'm Steve Woodman. We'll see you tomorrow for Steve's Place, 3 to 6. In the meantime, have yourselves a good night, won't you?
From Vancouver, British Columbia, Canada, this is 50,000 watt CKWX 1130.
Good evening, this is Campbell McCubbin in the CKWX newsroom. Vancouver's temperature is 47 degrees. Skies are clouding over. It's going to be mostly cloudy tonight and tomorrow, but sunny skies should prevail by noon.
I bought a new Mazda the other day. It's a great new car, the people all say. Got a rotary engine, goes round and round, instead of those pistons that go up and down. Piston engine goes, but the Mazda goes. You can't hear the valves, you can't hear the cam. It's got fewer parts, so there's nothing to jam. No rods or pistons to rub or grind. Just a rotary engine you can really wind. Piston engine goes, but the Mazda goes. So if you're getting tired of costly repair and you want the mechanics out of your hair, do what I did and save some brain. Go out and get yourself the clean machine. Piston engine goes, but the Mazda goes.
Now, CKWX Evening Report News to 6. The minority Liberal government is in for a non-confidence vote in the Commons tonight over the sale of the Polymer Corporation to the Canada Development Corporation. Doug Taylor takes a look ahead.
The Liberals, of course, defending the sale of Polymer to Canada Development Corporation. Otto Lang saying the move was honorable. But Tory leader Robert Stanfield, leading the way to the non-confidence vote, is charging that the sale is dishonest, a gimmick by the Trudeau government to set up the CDC. At one point, Tory House Leader Jed Baldwin shouted across at the Liberal members, "How many shares did you buy in CDC?" Stanfield has pledged that if he is ever Prime Minister, he'll rescind the sale. But despite the shouting and charges, the minority Liberal government is expected to survive the vote. David Lewis, who in the past condemned the sale, now says he'll support the government against the Tories, justifying his move by saying he wants the Liberals to survive until after the bill to increase the old age pensions. That vote will come probably tomorrow. Mr. Stanfield charged that David Lewis is getting tiring and boring. At this moment, there are fewer than 100 members in the House, but when the bells ring for the vote, they'll all file back in. Doug Taylor, Selkirk News, Ottawa.
The good news has finally arrived for the Opals of Courtney. Their son, Lloyd, held by the communists in Laos and North Vietnam for many months now, will be released on Wednesday. U.S. sources in Saigon report that Opal should be freed by the path at Laos with 9 Americans captured in Laos at that time. Earlier this afternoon, I broke the news to Lloyd's father, Magnus Opal.
Good, that's wonderful. I'm just on my way to the hospital to visit my wife.
Well, you'll have some good news to pass along to her then, eh?
Yes, yes, it sure is good news, because I heard over the news that a little while ago, you know, that they were going to be released, but it didn't mention Lloyd, and you say this now mentions Lloyd, eh?
Oh, yes, the people in Saigon, United States group in Saigon, say he will be released with the 9 Americans on Wednesday.
Well, isn't that wonderful? Praise the Lord. Thank you very much, sir, for letting us know.
The voice of Magnus Opal. Meantime, the federal government's announcement on whether Canada will remain on the four-member International Commission of Control and Supervision should be made tomorrow. Canada's initial 60-day commitment to monitor the truce expires on Wednesday. The cabinet must now decide whether to stay on the commission, to extend its commitment for a limited period, or to pull out entirely within a few days. We asked External Affairs Minister Mitchell Sharp about reports of late that the U.S. has been arm-twisting Canada to stay on the commission.
No, the United States has been urging us to remain, but there's been no undue pressure, no twisting of arms. It's much the same story as I've heard from the Japanese and from the British and from the Chinese and from Saigon and from some of our allies in NATO. They would like us to remain.
The release of the last 148 American prisoners in Indochina begins within hours, along with the withdrawal of the remaining U.S. troops in Vietnam. The impasse over the release of 9 American prisoners held by the communist backpath at Laos was resolved today, and all U.S. prisoners will be released by Thursday. Here at home, this province is now unique in Canada, in that it still has to grapple with an elevator strike. Sandy Price looks at the situation tonight.
BC elevator constructors, together with their maritime counterparts, remain the only holdout groups in the 7-month nationwide elevator strike. This despite the strikes being declared illegal in BC. Union officials here met throughout the day but remained silent as to their plans. It was understood they were waiting for the Ontario dispute to be settled. It could be the BC boys are not happy with the government-imposed settlement that will come there. Spokesman for Otis Elevator in Vancouver, W.D. Fox, says the manufacturers have met among themselves but not with the union, and no meetings are scheduled. Fox says there's really nothing to do but wait for union action, and the union members show no intention of going to work tomorrow. Sandy Price, CKWX News.
Any contractor in this province who wants to be awarded government contracts will have to hire union labor in the future, or it's no deal. The government today introduced legislation to that effect. Labor Minister Bill King says a considerable number of contracts in the past did go to non-union contractors.
Considerable amount was, yes. Under the previous legislation, the Minister of Labor did have the power, of course, to regulate conditions of employment and the wage structure if it came into dispute. Under this new bill, it will obviate the need for the Minister of Labor to intervene directly, because those matters will be decided through the collective bargaining process.
Legislation regarding bargaining rights for BC civil servants is only about a week away. That news today from Provincial Secretary Ernie Hall, who says the legislation is now in draft form. Resources Minister Bob Williams has announced the start of production tonight at Ocean Falls under government ownership will come very soon.
We have every reason to expect that the startup will be April 3rd, which is quite encouraging because Crown Zellerbach leaves March the 29th. So that's very encouraging. It'll be the number 4 machine that should be in production with Kraft initially, and the other machines can be phased in at a later stage.
Meantime, the BC forest industry has been warned that it better improve its public image before the NDP government starts taking a close look at it. The president of Weyerhaeuser Canada Limited, Tom Rust, told the Canadian Forestry Association today the industry is looked upon by critics as rapists of the forest, polluters of the streams and the atmosphere. Rust warned that a provincial government committee is going to be touring British Columbia in just a few months to look at forest company operations.
What we need to do is to communicate and take aggressive action to prove we are living up to our responsibilities. If we are not living up to them, then it is up to us to change our practices and not wait until we are forced into changes by legislative action.
The provincial government had good news today for those interested in daycare but who perhaps can't afford it. They've introduced an expanded program which will see the government able to subsidize the costs to families on a sliding scale of income and family size. Rehab Minister Norm Levy explains.
The effect of this new program will be to make more children able to enjoy the benefits of daycare. For the first time, the government will be reaching beyond the low-income levels to assist the average income earner with daycare costs. You'll notice that there are possibilities of people making $900 a month. Depending on the number of people in their family, can also get some kind of assistance. It's open to subsidies for people in group daycare, family daycare, preschool, nursery school, private kindergartens, where there's no daycare exists. We're doing this because the government recognizes that good daycare is beneficial to children.
Two top officials of the Vancouver Canucks appeared in court today and pleaded not guilty to charges arising out of money transfers within the organization and its parent company, Medicor. Tom Scallon and Lyman Walters are both charged with publishing a false prospectus. Scallon also charged with theft. An industrial accident in Burnaby today took the life of a 50-year-old man. 50-year-old Dominic Patrignani, operating a concrete pumper owned by Marcanto Concrete, was electrocuted and burned when the machine struck a 12,000-volt power line and burst into flames. The accident occurred on a construction site at Halifax and Willingdon in Burnaby. And in Washington tonight, 20 finance ministers, including John Turner of Canada, started 2 days of meetings in Washington to speed up the work on international monetary reform. That meeting follows the major currency reshuffle in which the U.S. devalued its dollar and all major currencies began floating against it. I'll have detailed weather in just a minute.
A lot of things have grown around your home since you moved in. The bushes, the trees, and probably your family. And one more thing you might not be aware of. The equity you have in your home. The difference between what it's worth today and what you still owe on the mortgage. And that difference could provide you with up to $10,000 from Household Realty Corporation. Household's up to $10,000 real estate loan is designed to let the homeowner borrow at a special HFC rate to get the things he needs today. A car, vacation property, just name it. And it's yours with Household's up to $10,000 real estate loan.
Never borrow money needlessly, but when you need to borrow, you get more than money at HFC.
There are 19 household finance offices in the Vancouver area. See your phone book for the office nearest you. You borrow with confidence at HFC.
Now out to the weather office at the airport, and here's the public forecaster.
Good evening. Here's the forecast for Greater Vancouver. Tonight, mainly cloudy. Tuesday, cloudy, becoming sunny around noon. Lows overnight, mid-30s. Highs Tuesday, lower 50s. And the Wednesday outlook, mainly sunny.
Outside CKWX tonight, it's 47 degrees. This is Campbell McCubbin for CKWX News, another dependable Selkirk news station serving British Columbia. CKWX time is 10 and 3 quarters past 6.
CKWX Vancouver.
Now from the weather office, the small craft weather bulletin issued at 4:30. Sandheads was cloudy south at 3 and rippled. First Narrows, cloudy west 8 and rippled. Atkinson, cloudy west 5 and rippled. Merry Island, overcast, west-southwest at 4 and rippled. Comox, partly cloudy, north-northeast at 6. Sisters, partly cloudy, west 5 and rippled. Entrance, cloudy, northwest 10 and choppy. Saturna, partly cloudy, calm and smooth. And Victoria, overcast, south at 9. The next report on CKWX at 6:05 tomorrow morning.
The K Theater Restaurant proudly presents all this week the exotic melodic sounds of Arthur Lyman and his Hawaiian show. Tonight only, two admissions for the price of one. For reservations, call The Cave at 682-3677. And listen to Arthur Lyman tonight on The Terry Moore Show at 7:05. CKWX time is 12 minutes now, past 6 o'clock. Time to look at the world of sport, and here is J. Paul McConnell.
Thank you, Terry. Good evening, everyone. As is so often the case these days in the world of sport, the main topic tonight is money. The 8 teams involved in the NHL playoffs this year will get...